Distinguished guests, ladies and gentlemen, good morning and welcome to the United States Army Training and Doctrine Command Change of Command Ceremony. The commander of troops for today's ceremony is Lieutenant General Maria R. Gervais, Deputy Commanding General, United States Army Training and Doctrine Command. We would like to welcome the Secretary of the Army, the Honorable Christine Wormuth, the Sergeant Major of the Army, Michael Grinston, the United States Army Forces Command Commanding General, General Andrew Pappas, Headquarters Air Combat Command Commanding General, General Mark Kelly. We would also like to extend warm greetings to general officers, commanders, command sergeants major, and members of the Greater Virginia Peninsula. The troops arrayed on the field include the United States Army Combined Arms Center, commanded by Lieutenant General Theodore Martin and his Command Sergeant Major Stephen Helton. The United States Army Center for Initial Military Training, commanded by Major General John Klein and his Command Sergeant Major Scott Beeson. The United States Army Training Center and Fort Jackson, commanded by Brigadier General Jason Kelly and his Command Sergeant Major Philson Tavernier. The United States Army Cadet Command, commanded by Major General Johnny Davis and his Command Sergeant Major Jeremiah Gann. The United States Army Recruiting Command, commanded by Major General Kevin Vereen and his Sergeant Major John Foley. The Maneuver Center of Excellence, commanded by Major General Curtis Buzzard and his Command Sergeant Major Derek Garner. The Fire Centers of Excellence, commanded by Major General Kenneth Camper and his Command Sergeant Major Stephen Burnley. The Maneuver Support Center of Excellence, commanded by Major General James Bonner and his Command Sergeant Major Randolph Delpina. The Sustainment Center of Excellence, commanded by Major General Mark Simmerly and his Command Sergeant Major Marker Torres. The Intelligence Center of Excellence, commanded by Major General Anthony Hill and his Command Sergeant Major Tammy Everett. The Cyber Center of Excellence, commanded by Major General Paul Stanton and his Command Sergeant Major Delia Quintero. The Aviation Center of Excellence, commanded by Major General Michael McCurry and his Command Sergeant Major James Wilson. The Medical Center of Excellence, commanded by Major General Michael Talley and his Command Sergeant Major Victor Larajian. The Non-Commissioned Officer Learning Center of Excellence, led by Command Sergeant Major Jason Schmidt. The 80th Training Command, commanded by Major General Boland Bowles III and his Command Sergeant Major Christopher Luschinger. And the 108th Training Command, led by Brigadier General Jeffrey Ferris. Also participating in today's ceremony, the TRADOC Band, commanded by Major Day Kim. Singing the national anthem is Mr. Ron Henry. The Color Guard is comprised of non-commissioned officers from the 128th Aviation Brigade, led by the United States Army Training and Doctrine Command Sergeant Major, Command Sergeant Major Daniel T. Hendricks. The Salute Battery is comprised of soldiers from Bravo Company, 1st of the 222nd Aviation Regiment, and is led by Sergeant First Class Siliavo Litalu. This morning, General Paul E. Funk II relinquishes command of the United States Army Training and Doctrine Command to General Gary M. Brito. The host for today's ceremony is General James C. McConville, 40th Chief of Staff of the Army. Ladies and gentlemen, please direct your attention to the adjutant as she begins the ceremony by directing the band to sound attention. Ladies and gentlemen, please stand for the arrival of the official party and honors to the host performed by the TRADOC Band and Salute Battery. General McConville has deferred honors to General Funk. Please remain standing for the invocation by the TRADOC Command Chaplain, Chaplain Colonel Gregory Edison. General McConville is accompanied in the official party by the outgoing commander, General Funk, and the incoming commander, General Brito. The invocation offered today is from the TRADOC Chaplain, Chaplain Colonel Edison.
Will you please join me for a word of prayer? In the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit, we invoke your divine presence on today's ceremony between General Funk and General Brito. We express our sincere gratitude for an American soldier, General Funk, and his strength of character, firmness of purpose, and unwavering commitment. His command has been one of emotional intelligence, innovative leadership, and genuine care. Whereas his emotional intelligence has made us smarter professionals, his innovative leadership elevated TRADOC's recruitment, training, and education functions and capabilities. And his genuine care has left an indelible mark. May your peace, prosperity, and protection be with General Funk and Dr. Funk as they don the Soldier for Life jersey. We ask now your blessings upon General Brito as he once again assumes the sacred mantle of leadership. Grant him divine favor as he emphasizes the Army values, exercises discretionary judgment, and leads TRADOC to the next phase of shaping our Army to remain the nation's force of decisive action. Please grant that General Brito and his wife, Michelle, experience unlimited divine success and fulfillment in command. Victory starts here for God and country, amen.
Ladies and gentlemen, at this time, please be seated. At this time, Staff Sergeant Shane Civitello is presenting a bouquet of red roses to Dr. Elizabeth Funk, a tradition symbolizing her support and contributions to the soldiers and families of TRADOC. Red is the color of the heart and reflects the love and concern she has shown the soldiers, families, and civilians of the command. The roses are in full bloom, symbolizing the fulfillment of her time with us here at TRADOC. Flowers are also being presented to General Funk's mother, Mrs. Danny Funk. At this time, Staff Sergeant Toniel Ivory is presenting a bouquet of yellow rosebuds to General Brito's wife, Mrs. Michelle Brito. Yellow is the color of new beginnings and friendship. In time, the rosebuds will open, symbolizing relationships that will blossom over time here at TRADOC. Coins are also presented to General Brito's sons, Mr. Matthew Brito and Captain Patrick Brito. To commemorate this special occasion, First Sergeant Robert Mitchell will now present General Funk a shell casing which commemorates the last round fired during today's ceremony. Ladies and gentlemen, please stand for the national anthem performed by Mr. Ron Henry.
Oh, say can you see by the dawn's early light what so proudly we hailed at the twilight's last gleaming, whose broad stripes and bright stars through the perilous fight, o'er the ramparts we watched, were so gallantly streaming. And the rocket's red glare, the bombs bursting in air, gave proof through the night that our flag was still there. Oh, say does that star-spangled banner yet wave o'er the land and of the free and the home of the brave?
Ladies and gentlemen, please be seated. The colors under which a military unit exists symbolize its very soul. The colors record the unit's achievements and have been used by armies for centuries. In 17th century Europe, their different colored flags identified regiments. The colors led the regiment into battle despite often heavy casualties suffered by the color bearers. To capture the enemy's colors was the highest achievement the victors could claim. Today, the colors are passed to the new commander by the outgoing commander, symbolizing the changing of command. Since each individual soldier cannot be passed to the new commander, the unit's flag is used to represent the change and identify the new commander to each soldier under his charge. The command sergeant major is the guardian of the unit colors and represents continuity during the change of command. By authority of Army Regulation 600-20, the undersigned assumes command of the United States Army Training and Doctrine Command. Signed, General Gary M. Brito, United States Army Commanding. Ladies and gentlemen, the Chief of Staff of the Army, General James C. McConville.
Well, good morning, and victory starts here. And yes, it does. And in our Army, winning matters. And that's what this why it is so important. What happens here. You know, every day is a great day to be in the United States Army because we serve with the world's greatest soldiers who are represented before us today. And today is an especially great day here at TRADOC because we recognize the achievements of this command. We celebrate the leadership of Paul and Beth Funk, and we welcome back Gary and Michelle Brito. But before I get started, I'd like to welcome our distinguished guests, our Secretary, the Honorable Christine Warmoth, General Mark Kelly, I think from the Joint Team is here. Thanks for joining us. General Drew Pappas, Force Comm Commander, Sergeant Major of the Army, Grinston, Miss Yvette Buzico, Mr. Michael Formiker, Lieutenant General Butch Funk, Paul's dad, sir, thank you for being here. And General Kip Ward, sir, thank you for being here. And I think our CARSes, Ms. Braswell and Mr. Flanagan are here. Thank you. And I think we have some Gold Star families here, and thank you also. Fellow general officers, commanders, command sergeant majors, DA civilians, senior warrant officers, non-commissioned officers, soldiers, local civilian leaders, family and friends, thank you for being here for this extremely important event. I'd like to give a special welcome to the Funk and Brito family members who are here, many who have traveled from Texas, the great state of Massachusetts, a little bias there, Florida, Georgia, and thank you all for making it here today and making this ceremony so special. You know, as we all know, the United States Army exists for one purpose, and that is to protect the nation by being ready to fight and win the nation's wars as a member of the Joint Force. And we are living in very challenging times. And for me, probably the potentially most dangerous in recent history. You know, take a look at what's going on in Russia, in Asia. Threats from North Korea and Iran have not gone away, and neither has violent extremism. And we're still dealing with COVID and upcoming natural disasters. And on top of it, we're working through a very challenging recruiting environment. But these may be challenging, dangerous times, but our entire Army, and especially TRADOC, remains ready to meet these challenges so we remain the world's greatest fighting force. And what this command has done over the last few years under the leadership of General Paul Funk is truly remarkable. You know, during the COVID-19, and you know, right now we're here, no one's wearing masks, people are sitting together, but it wasn't too long ago where we had to work through a situation where we had to recruit virtually. We had to figure out how we're going to train in a very dangerous environment. And TRADOC never stopped. Paul and the TRADOC team adapted, and they found innovative solutions so we could continue to recruit and train our soldiers, because the dangerous situations in our world had not gone away. And under Paul's steady leadership, you know, TRADOC figured out how to modify our procedures so we could safely continue basic training and institutional education across the Army. And all the while, TRADOC continued to evolve our doctrine, our education, our leader development, and our training. You know, our Army, as all you know, is undergoing the greatest transformation in over 40 years. As we transition from two decades of counterinsurgency and counterterrorism to refocus on large-scale combat operations like we're seeing in Ukraine today. And TRADOC has enabled us to move forward in that transformation under the outstanding leadership of General Paul Funk. And the talented civilians and soldiers across TRADOC, the five subordinate commands and the 10 centers of excellence that are standing before you today. And when Paul took over TRADOC, the multi-domain operations was a concept. And under his leadership and your hard work, its evolution is becoming doctrine, and we'll publish that doctrine in October with lessons learned from Ukraine. He operationalized the Army People Strategy, focusing on building positive command climates, reducing harmful behaviors, and driving change across our Army. Changed the way, you all changed the way we look at fitness under the Holistic Health and Fitness Program, which is allowing our soldiers to serve without getting the injuries they have in the past. And you all and he have championed countless initiatives to include revamping basic combat training, modernizing the Captain's Career Course, and fielding the Army Combat Fitness Test. You led the creation of our Project Athena Leader Development Tool to prepare Army leaders for our Commander's Assessment Program, transforming the selection process of our most consequential leaders in our Army, our battalion and brigade commanders and sergeant majors. And although we've faced some recruiting challenges, TRADOC has created the Future Soldier Preparatory Course at Fort Jackson, which is going to allow us to maintain standards and to invest in American youth, and I believe will transform the way that we bring American youth into the Army. We will invest in them, we will not lower standards, and we will get them to meet our standards. And so for me, TRADOC is the people command. For every one of us in uniform, this is where it starts, and I said before, this is where victory starts here. And that's why we have the world's greatest Army, because of what you all do to bring in great soldiers and to train those soldiers so they can be part of the Army team. And the Army would not be what it is without the hard work of all the soldiers and civilians that are here. When you think about it, TRADOC trains and educates over 500,000 soldiers, non-commissioned officers, warrant officers, and officers every single year. They recruit and assess tens of thousands of soldiers every year. They train every single sergeant to be the backbone of our Army. They train over 20,000 cadets in ROTC every single year. And when those cadets become officers, TRADOC trains them to assume their first mantle of leadership. Also, other servicemen and women across the Joint Force, along with our allies and partners, go through the training that TRADOC conducts. So the impact of TRADOC is not only on our Army, but the Joint Force and land forces all around the world. So again, thank you all for what you do every single day. You know, we recruit soldiers, but we retain families. So I'd like to thank all the families of TRADOC for their support and commitment to our soldiers in our Army. And Paul, while we'll celebrate your retirement in a ceremony tomorrow, I would like to say a few words here. I'd like to thank your family, especially your parents, Lieutenant General retired Butch Funk, the first, and Mom, Danny, for your service and your commitment and for inspiring Paul to serve this country so well he's done. You ought to be real proud of the young man that you all have raised. And Paul, thank you and Beth for over 38 years of distinguished service to the nation and what you have done for our people here. You are leaving behind a legacy of service, a legacy of taking care of people, and I can't leave out the legacy of Funk's fundamentals, all 40 of them. You are the leader our Army needed, a leader who understood that you don't have to choose between taking care of people and keeping our Army strong and ready to protect the nation and its allies. We wish you and Beth good luck and Godspeed on your well-deserved next rendezvous with destiny. You know, this morning we promoted Gary to 4-star in front of his family and friends. He has all the qualities we are looking for in our leaders today, the competence, the commitment, the character, and the utmost care for people. I have complete trust and confidence that TRADOC is in good hands with him and Michelle. He is the right person at the right time to lead this organization. And I know he will continue to lead our Army's transformation and continue to take care of our people. And you know, in our Army, it's about people first. Winning does matter, and that's why victory starts here, and that's how we remain Army strong. Thank you, and God bless each and every one of you.
Ladies and gentlemen, General Paul E. Funk II.
Well, good morning, everybody. You couldn't ask for a greater day. And Grace, I got to tell you, the flyover was a little early. But I appreciate you backing it up with the geese. Thank you. That's why we're a joint base, by golly. So when I first got here to TRADOC, I didn't have to put these glasses on. Now I do. So good morning, everyone. To the distinguished guests, family, friends, and soldiers and civilians of the TRADOC team, welcome. My name is Funk, and I'm an American soldier. Secretary Wormuth, General McCombell, and Maria, Sergeant Major Grinston, and all of my 4-star friends, thank you for being here today. Special shout out to our family for traveling once again, part of another transition. You truly honor us with our presence. And I think my Uncle Bill may get the record for coming all the way from Roundup, Montana. So how about a big round of applause? To my incredible team that I recognized last week, you know how important you are to me and how much our service together matters. It would be too hard to recognize everyone, but I'd like to give a special shout out to the distinguished alumni from Montana State University, Brian and Tom, and also to my good friend John Miller and his wife Polly, and Mike Tarz as well. But John Miller is my longest serving teammate as we played high school football and baseball together. Thanks for being here today. What a great day. What a great day it is to leave the helm of the United States Army's Training and Doctrine Command in the incredibly capable hands of our good friends Gary and Michelle Britoff. I know ceremonies like this are difficult to plan and execute. So if you would, please give a big round of applause to everyone who worked so hard to make this world-class event and special recognition to our ESO team. And there are far too many world-class leaders for me to mention, but I can't go any further without mentioning Command Sergeant Major Dan Hendricks and his wife, Christina. Their focus on people first has been extraordinary, and we are a better organization because of it. And to Christina, thanks for being a great friend to my Beth. When I assumed command 3 years ago, we, the Centers of Excellence commanders and Command Sergeant Majors, the Accessions Command Team, Recruiting and Cadet Command, the Center of Military History, the Soldier for Life Program, and Fort Jackson, which is now the gateway to the Army, took a hard look at how to structure TRADOC's efforts to drive change. And from that, we developed the TRADOC campaign plan. Our five lines of effort, acquire, people, improve, build, and reform, are not a complete list of everything we do, but rather a framework for what TRADOC does. Many people are unaware of all that TRADOC does for our nation. So today, I want to brag on these men and women right here. Our acquire line of effort is our main priority. It's no secret that the current accessions environment is tough, but we, just like the rest of the nation, are in a competition for talent. Our acquisitions enterprise, led by the indomitable Lieutenant General Maria Gervais, is all about preserving the all-volunteer force and giving America's youth the opportunity to serve. And we're doing everything to expand that opportunity through the Future Soldier Prep course. And I was at Fort Jackson just a few weeks ago, and I saw the Future Soldier Prep course in action. I looked in the eyes of those young men and women attending, and it was clear that they knew that they had to meet our standards and were willing to work hard to do so. We want young men and women who will go the extra mile. We want young men and women who are resilient and know how to overcome challenges. I truly believe that the Future Soldier Prep course is creating opportunity, and it's going to change how we recruit. To me, it's the essence of what TRADOC does. It gives young men and women opportunities, and it changes lives. Our second line of effort is people. It is the very foundation of the campaign plan. After all, according to Funk Fundamental Number 25, the Army is a people business. People first is all about training, and that's exactly what the Army Holistic Health and Fitness Program is all about. It's more than just the Army Combat Fitness Test. It's revolutionizing how we look at fitness. We need to be able to fight outnumbered and win, and that's why we exist, and exactly why we've invested tremendous time and resources into the Army's Holistic Health and Fitness Program. We focused on changing culture, focused on our values, and holding each other accountable, treating each other with dignity and respect. We are America's Army. Our strength is our diversity, and we've used our monthly Leader to Professional Development program to have some incredible conversations. We're leading the Army on identifying ways to break down barriers to continued service for all soldiers through our Women's Initiatives team. And we had the privilege of hosting the Warrior Games on behalf of the Department of Defense. The Warrior Games were nothing short of extraordinary, a true world-class event to celebrate the recovery journeys of our incredible warrior athletes and their families. Also, I'd be remiss not to highlight our tremendous civilian employees led by Mike Formica. We've made incredible strides in our civilian accessions efforts. Our intern program is phenomenal. It's injected enthusiasm, youth, vigor throughout the enterprise, and it highlights that serving in uniform is not the only path to serve. Our third line is to build, focus on TRADOC's role leading the DOTLM integration to build the Army of 2030. CAC, led by Lieutenant General Ted Martin, is doing a magnificent job. Doctrine is our foundation, and right now, FM 3.0 multi-domain operations is setting the way we'll fight for the next generation. And our G2 team, whose efforts have led across the threat doctrine, are nothing short of world-class and proof that the G2 work is used across the Army. Fourth line is to improve, and it is so important to our organization. The COVID pandemic gave us an opportunity to improve our training, leader development, and education programs at an incredible speed. We changed over 1,200 courses in just 2.5 years. I'm immensely proud that TRADOC only paused for 2 weeks to set the medical conditions and then got right back to training during COVID. In fact, organizations from across the world came to learn how to combat the pandemic and continue to grow and develop. Remember, Funk's Fundamental 15 no idea. A good idea is only great when it is shared. Our fifth line of effort is reform, and it's all about TRADOC getting better at producing the best soldiers in the world. We needed to move our processes from the industrial age to the information age, and that's exactly what we're doing. I'm really excited about how we changed basic combat training. Transitions are the biggest point of friction in any organization, so we had to adapt the way we bring young men and women into our team. The first 100 yards, thunder run, into the breach. These are NCO-led and NCO resources exercises that begin to build the journey of trust. And these things are making people excited about the team they're joining. And as a result, the young men and women we're putting out on the field are much better prepared to do their soldier tasks. Since the initiatives I mentioned are just a few of the hundreds of amazing things this organization has accomplished, if I had to summarize our impact over the last 3 years, it would be how TRADOC is driving positive change for our people. We learned, we grew, we adapted, and we did it together. It's been the honor of my life to wear the cloth of our great nation for more than 38 years. And as I close out my career, there are many things I'm proud of, but none more than serving as the 17th Commanding General of the United States Army's Training and Doctrine Command. The most important thing I am leaving here is that I'm leaving here with that beautiful lady in the blue dress for 38 years by my side, out front, and leading our teams. Honey, you're amazing, and I love you to death. Can't wait for the next chapter. The Funks are so grateful to everyone for grabbing an oar and rowing. So from us to you, thank you. Thanks for changing lives. Thanks for being part of something bigger than yourself and taking on these tasks. My family and I recognize just how amazingly talented you all are, and we've loved being on your team. Gary and Michelle, Beth and I are proud to hand over this world-class team that is ready to continue driving change, and we can't wait to see where you lead them. As I said when I started, my name is Funk, and I'm an American soldier, and victory starts right here. Thank you.
Ladies and gentlemen, the Commanding General, United States Army Training and Doctrine Command, General Gary M. Brito.
Well, General Funk, it's my first day. I'm already wearing glasses, so. Good morning, everybody, everyone, to the distinguished guest mentioned in the opening remarks, families and friends, and so, well, wrong speech. Shouldn't have thought of that one. First page, anyway. Good morning, ladies and gentlemen, distinguished guests and fellow general officers. Thank you for attending today. Secretary Warmoth and Chief, again, thank you for your trust and confidence, and I am extremely humbled and honored to serve our Army as the 18th Commanding General of the Training Doctrine Command, TRADOC, and joining a great team of soldiers and civilians. Thank you, General Funk and Dr. Funk, Paul and Beth, for two things. One, for your distinguished and outstanding leadership, sir. And two, for your unwavering support to the soldiers, civilians, and families of TRADOC and our Army. Your impactful, enduring contributions to this fight, and as you mentioned, for over 38 plus years of dedicated service to our great nation. And I thank you for that, as do the soldiers and civilians that these soldiers on the field represent. And Paul, I'm not sure which fundamental it is, but as you would say, thank you for leaving your jersey in a better place. I'd like to give a collective shout out to one big group of soldiers. That's the firing battery, the band, these guidon bearers, and Ron, who sang that amazing rendition of the National Anthem. Let's take 5 seconds to give all of them a round of applause.
Ron, I don't know if I wanted to re-enlist or go to church, but that was amazing. Well done. Hey, to my wife, Michelle, and sons, Matthew and Patrick, in addition to what was mentioned earlier this morning at the promotion, I know that I am not on this journey alone, and I appreciate your support in being the epitome of the Army family. And boys, I mentioned your accomplishments earlier. Can't express the pride I have and the love I have for you and your mom, and thank you for all that you do. Team TRADOC's efforts are essential and foundational to ensuring our Army remains the most lethal fighting force in the world, now and into the future. And I being part of this team, promise you that we are committed to that very end. And as the Chief mentioned, our motto, Victory Starts Here, it indeed has some meaning and meat behind it. And I would like to share just a few personal thoughts. Victory. It is the most essential thing that our Army exists to do, to fight and win our nation's wars. We owe it to our country, we owe it to the American people, and to the soldiers, civilians, and families who fill its ranks. We must and will turn every challenge into an opportunity in order to prevail, because as the boss said, winning matters. Starts. TRADOC is where the Army life begins, period. It is where we make and maintain contact with the communities we serve, where we help those willing to serve find a path to be all they can be. It is where we transform civilians into soldiers, where the warrior ethos is forged and experts and leaders are built. It is where theory, big ideas, design, and requirements are codified into real practice, doctrine, training that guides our Army now into the future. We are the foundation. We are the start. Here, victory starts here. The here is all of us. It is in the halls and the closets of the 10 centers of excellence across this nation. It is in the 33 Army schools, the hundreds of ROTC and JROTC programs, the 1,400 plus recruiting stations, and represented by the commanders and command sergeant majors on the field today. More importantly, the here is the 40,000 soldiers and the 14,000 civilians that make our mission happen every day. So TRADOC, you drive this engine. We are the here, and victory starts here. And team, I am honored and humbled and excited to lead this great command and be part of a great transformational team at a great transformational time in our Army and our nation and our Army's history. Thanks for the pleasure of your company this morning. People first, winning matters, Army strong, and victory starts here. Thank you, ladies and gentlemen.
Ladies and gentlemen, please rise for the playing of the Army song and remain standing for the departure of colors. Words to the Army song are included in your program. We invite you to sing along. Ladies and gentlemen, this concludes today's ceremony. Please feel free to meet General and Dr. Funk in the front of the event stand. The receiving line begins to the Funk's right. General Brito will host a reception inside the Fort Eustis Club for invited guests. Thank you for attending today's ceremony. Victory starts here.